Hey y'all, this is Reddy Ants. I'm Play, culture editor at Now Magazine. We are going to be spending today with Maitri Ramakrishnan, the star of Never Have I Ever, which you can catch on Netflix. Maitri Ramakrishnan, as you know, was born and raised in Mississauga, Ontario. And what we're going to be doing today is we're going to be exploring the sites of Toronto, of Mississauga, all the places that have had a big impact on her, the places that she represents when she goes abroad to the globe, representing Toronto to the rest of the world. So let's bring her in. Maitri Ramakrishnan, come on over.
Hey, yo.
How are you?
I am good. That was a great intro.
Oh, thank you. So we are at St. Lawrence Market, which you picked as a special spot for you. Now, St. Lawrence Market, for those who don't know, is it's basically Toronto's first farmer's market. It's about 200 years old. That building behind us is from like 1850. This is also the spot of Toronto's first city hall. They used to hold like town hall meetings on the outside. Yeah.
So I did not know that.
This is the center of it all. But this is also the first spot that you wanted to showcase. So tell us why. Why St. Lawrence Market?
Okay, this might be like a little weird spot to like pick of all of Toronto, but there's like a good reason, okay? So basically, probably when I was around like 13-ish, my mom had a work trip here in Toronto and she got to stay up in like some cool hotel and she let me come with her. So I was like, okay, yeah, for sure, I'll come. And then when she had to go do like work things, she was like, yeah, like go have fun. Like, go wherever, and I was like by myself. So it was the first time I got to like walk around like in a big city by myself. I had my mom's phone with me because she had data, I did not. So, you know, that was good. But the first place I went was here. So I was like, okay, this is like pretty cool. They have food here. I like food. And I bought ice cream and no one could tell me I couldn't. And there was like a waffle with it and no one could say I couldn't get the waffle with it too. It was my own money by myself. And it was like that first moment of like independence.
All right, so now we're gonna go to our next spot, which is the real City Hall. We are at Toronto City Hall. And I don't know why we're here.
We are here for everything but City Hall. No shade to City Hall. But hear me out. Okay, so when I was 13, 14, that was when like the Pan Am Games was like, you know, doing all of its promotion like here in Toronto. Mm-hmm. So they did like a bunch of concerts and like other things to like get people, you know, hyped for that. And I saw that Mariana's Trench was gonna do a little concert. And I was like, oh my God. I grabbed my childhood best friend. We were ready to start performing. And what happened was they were like the headline act. They were at the very, very end. But we stayed here till like 7 a.m, waited all the way past 12. And we finally got to see Mariana's Trench. I was super excited because they were my favorite band since like I was 7, my cousin's influence. Shout out to her. But yeah, I sought out to see Josh Ramsey in person. I saw Josh Ramsey in person. It was a win.
Were you in tears?
I was in tears for the longest time. I didn't understand why people cry at concerts. I was like, that's really weird. That's a really weird flex. And then I bawled, like on spot. I think somebody who wasn't Josh Ramsey came out just like to do like tech things. Yeah, and we all thought it was. And I already was like dying.
It was really
embarrassing. But first concert experience, pretty cool. So yeah.
And can I, in terms of the tears thing, I can feel you. I know, like, I always mock people for tearing up at this happy moment of joy. For me, it was the first time I watched The Godfather in a movie theater, and a tear came to my eye. That was my moment.
That's so weirdly artsy.
Okay, well, is this weird, though? Like, you're talking about Mariana Trench, and I have no idea who they are. So, I'm sorry,
Canadian David. Icons, and I can't.
No, you're the new Canadian icon. All right, let's go check out the next place.
Okay, next place, let's go.
All right. The AGO?
AGO, it's spelt out in big letters for you.
The Art Gallery of Ontario. So tell me, Maitri, why are we here?
Well, when I was like young, my mom would always take me to the AGO because, you know, art is really cool. So that was a big thing for me. And, you know, my mom would always tell me about like the Group of Seven and just all the different artists that I cared about. And I also always wanted to be an animator, go into that field, you know that.
Yeah, absolutely.
But, yeah, art was always a big deal to me and I would always love coming to the AGO because they always have really cool exhibits too.
What age?
Like seven-ish.
From seven-ish, yeah.
Seven-ish.
So this is not common among us immigrant folks, right? To nurture kind of that interest in arts and stuff like that, right?
Yeah.
Like I think whether you're brown, you're Asian, you're Chinese, whatever, you all know this this thing where immigrant families are like, what good are the arts? Doctor, lawyer, medicine, these engineering, these are the ways you go.
I think I've had my mom tell me not to become a doctor because I might accidentally kill people.
I do love your mom. She's saving lives. Okay, let's get to the next spot.
Okay, next spot. Saving lives, all right.
Saving lives. So we are in Kensington Market. You brought us to Kensington Market. This is where I come to get tacos and pupusas. Nice. What do you come to get in Kensington Market?
Well, my favorite thing is the churro place right here.
The churro place. Yeah. Okay, churros.
Churros, Pancho's Bakery. Yeah. It has the best churros. It is so good.
And what kind of churros?
Dulce de leche, then chocolate, and then not really caramel. I don't like caramel.
Yeah, that plain churro shit, take that back. We don't do that.
Who eats a plain churro?
If people try to serve me a plain churro, so I'm like, where's my dulce de leche?
Fair enough.
All right, next joint. Okay, so now we left Toronto. We came to your joint, your home, Mississauga, which got to represent the suburbs. And we are at the Owl of Minerva in Mississauga. Now, tell us about this joint. What is so special about Owl of Minerva?
24 hours. Yes, because, I mean, I'm a night owl. I, like, love just waking up at, like, 2 p.m. the earliest if I have a choice. And then just, you know, staying up all night. So when I have late night cravings, this is just a great place, you know? Yeah. Good old takeout, always dependable. There needs to be more 24-hour places. If I ever had my own restaurant, I would open a 24-hour place.
But when we talk about comfort food...
You can't do chopsticks?
I can't do chopsticks, I'm sorry.
Come on, no.
My son can... All right, fine.
Come on.
You're gonna teach me how to... Okay.
Do chopsticks.
Okay.
Come on. I was gonna ask you. I wanted to know.
You just saw me mauling with my hand.
No, you were testing me. I'm not judging. I just... Okay, that was terrible. But I had a feeling you can't do chopsticks.
How did you?
It was a gut instinct. Okay.
Okay.
Come.
So is this it? Am I doing this part right? Okay.
Oh,
okay. If this splashes, it's gonna be a mess.
Okay.
Like
this
it's
so
like
sad.
This is like I feel. Hold on. There we go. Ah. Oh. Well, that's so good though.
Is it good?
No, I mean dumpling is.
Have you ever been to Owl of Minerva before?
I've never been to an Owl of Minerva. I've never heard of it, but it's interesting.
I sort of just assume you have. I feel like everyone has.
Mm-mm.
It's not the case.
Because there's no Owl of Minerva's in Scarborough.
Okay, we're just gonna cover it.
I mean, but to say, like, in terms of comfort food, 24-hour comfort food, this is absolutely the stuff.
Right?
I know, growing up in Scarborough, it was initially Markham Station, then it was Perfect. It's like, especially when you're, like, coming off a long night, y'all gather there, and it was like, it became a community spot. I don't know if, is Owl of Minerva like a community spot for this location? Like, do people ever be like, I'll meet you at Owl of Minerva, or?
I don't know if it's like, I'll meet you there. Mm. I think it's more like a, I have late night cravings, let's go.
Mm.
I mean, my cousins and I have been here at like 3 a.m., but I don't mean like five of my cousins. I mean like at least 14, 16 of us with our aunts and uncles also here.
Right.
At 3 a.m. getting food. But then I've also been like, you know, with one friend and it's like, hey, let's go check out Olive Minerva, get some food.
Yeah.
It's just like, I'm hungry and I don't want to get anything from the fridge.
Okay, so thank you all for joining us. Thank you for watching this incredible food tour, and thank you for bringing us on this tour. And anything else you want to say?
Thank you for, you know, sticking around for my sentimental tour of Mississauga/Toronto and hearing me. Thanks for making it to the end of the video. If you haven't already, check out season 2 of Never Have I Ever on Netflix, and hope you have a great day. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm sorry. Not like that.
Okay.
No?
I don't know what that is.
All right.
I don't know what that is.